Dear students, today we shall discuss about the rDNA technology, recombinant DNA technology. Recombinant DNA technology is a major branch of genetic engineering, where the genetic setup of an individual is modified by introducing a new gene segment into it. rDNA technology is also referred as gene cloning. It deals with artificial modification of genetic constitution of living cell by introducing a foreign gene segment through experimental techniques. rDNA technology involves the identification and isolation of gene of interest from the selected organism, then introducing the gene of interest into the vector such as plasmid or bacteriophage to produce recombinant DNA, then production of large number of copies of that gene, that is gene cloning, or making the gene to express in the host cell. Vector DNA along with the incorporated foreign DNA segment gene of interest is called recombinant DNA or chimeric DNA or mosaic DNA. The overview of rDNA technology is, the first step is isolation of gene of interest from selected organism, either by using the genomic library or by using cDNA library. Second step is gene splicing. It is the incorporation of gene of interest selected from the selected organism into the plasmid to create recombinant DNA. Third step is introduction of gene of interest in the form of rDNA into the bacterial cell to bring about the transformation. Fourth step is screening of transformed cells or selection of transformed cells. Next step is gene cloning. It is amplification of gene of interest in the form of rDNA by culturing the transformed bacteria in the vitro or in bioreactor. And the last step is making the gene to express to produce non-bacterial protein. This is the overview. From the selected cell, the gene of interest is isolated. The genome is cut by using specific RNA into fragments. From the bacteria, the vector like plasmid is isolated. Plasmid is cut open, the gene of interest from the genomic library is introduced into the plasmid, creating rDNA. rDNA is introduced into the bacteria to bring about the transformation. Then the transformed bacteria are cultured in a culture medium to produce number of progeny of bacterial cells, and each bacterium having the rDNA, and each rDNA is having the introduced gene of interest. The biological tools that are required for rDNA technology are, major ones are enzymes. The most important enzymes are restriction endonucleases. These enzymes are also referred as, abbreviated as REN. They recognize a particular base sequence called palindromic sequence, which read same in either direction. On both the strands, the reading is same, that is from fifth end to third end. For example, the restriction endonuclease extracted from the E. coli, that is ECOR1, is able to recognize the palindromic sequence GAATTC. It cuts both the DNA strands in between G and E. producing the sticky ends. Sticky ends are complementary to each other. Palindromic sequence is the one which contain a sequence of 4 or 6 nucleotides which read same on either direction from 5th end to 3rd end. Another important enzymes are DNA ligase, which bring about the linking of DNA fragments, reverse transcriptase, which catalyzes the synthesis of DNA strand on the mRNA, alkaline phosphatase, which digests the phosphate group present at the 5th end, preventing the recircularization of plasmid, DNA polymerase to catalyze a DNA strand on the template, terminal transferase, which catalyzes the addition of nucleotides, converting the blunt ends into sticky ends. Then the vectors, the molecular vehicles, which transfer the gene of interest into the cell, into the bacterium, or into an organism. They are mainly plasmids, bacteriophages, lambdaphages, cosmids. Plasmids are the circular double-stranded DNA molecules present in the cytoplasm of bacteria. The first step in rDNA technology is isolation of gene of interest. The gene of interest can be picked either from the genomic library or from the cDNA library. In genomic library, the genome of a selected cell is isolated, purified, and cut into fragments by using limited number of restriction endonucleases. And the fragment of DNA has a sticky ends. Here, the rend are used as guided missiles to cut the DNA at particular point at this restriction site. cDNA library, where the DNA is synthesized on the mRNA by using the reverse transcriptase. Then the cDNA is made double-stranded. mRNA, the functional mRNA is intron-free. So we are getting a gene without any introns. This is the overview of isolation of gene of interest. One by using the rend, another by cDNA technology. In cDNA technology, the intron-free functional mRNA is isolated. Then this mRNA is made to synthesize a DNA strand on it by using the reverse transcriptase to produce a double-stranded one having one strand mRNA and the one cDNA. Then the mRNA is removed by using the sugar alkali or by using the RNase treatment, where the mRNA is digested, leaving the single-stranded cDNA. cDNA is made double-stranded by using the RNA polymerase, and cDNA, the sticky ends are added. Next step is gene splicing. Incorporation of gene of interest into the plasmid. The plasmid is isolated and treated with a specific rend to cut open it. The sticky ends of the rend and the gene of interest sticky ends must be complementary. The gene of interest is added, linked with the cut open plasmid, and DNA ligase enzyme is used to seal the gaps. So DNA ligase joins the gene of interest into the plasmid creating rDNA, recombinant DNA. Next step is gene splicing, that is the incorporation of gene of interest into the plasmid to create rDNA using DNA ligase. In this picture you can make out very clearly the gene of interest with the sticky and staggered cuts, and the plasmid is also cut with a staggered cut, and the staggered cuts of the gene of interest and staggered cuts of the plasmid are complementary. In this way the gene of interest is inserted into the plasmid to create rDNA. Next step is transformation, introducing the rDNA into the bacterium or into the host cell for gene cloning or for making the gene of interest to express in that host cell. The bacteria and rDNA molecules are incubated in cold calcium chloride solution for 12 hours. Then temperature is raised to 42 degrees centigrade suddenly, so that the permeability of the cell wall of bacterium, the permeability of the plasma membrane of the bacterium changes and the recombinant DNA makes an entry into the cell. Thus the bacteria has got new genes in the form of recombinant DNA. It is said to be transformed bacteria. Next step, the transformation of the host cell can be done by different methods. There are many methods of gene transfer. One that we have discussed is calcium chloride mediated gene transfer. Along with it, we are having biological methods of gene transfer, like agrobacterium mediated gene transfer in the plant biotechnology, virus mediated gene transfer in plant as well as in animal biotechnology, liposome mediated gene transfer, protoflast fusion. The chemical methods of gene transfer in addition to the calcium chloride mediated gene transfer are polyethylene glycol mediated gene transfer, calcium phosphate mediated gene transfer. Then we are having a physical methods also, like electroporation, micro injection and micro projectile or ballistic bombardment method. The next step is selection or screening of transformed bacteria. That all the bacteria will not take the recombinant DNA. Some have taken, some have not taken. The transformed bacteria are selected with the help of marker genes present in the vector DNA, which impart resistance to the biotics. For example, if the vector DNA has an ampicillin resistant gene, and if the transformed bacteria are cultured in a medium containing ampicillin, only these bacteria will be grown, whereas the other non-transformed bacteria will be killed. Next step is cloning of gene. Gene cloning is the amplification of gene of interest, producing many identical copies of genes, and it is done by culturing the transformed cells in vitro. The transformed bacteria multiply and the rate of reproduction in bacteria is very high there, so that one bacterium can produce two bacteria for every 20 minutes. In this way, in a sufficient culture medium and nutrients, the bacteria can produce number of daughter cells, and each daughter cells are having the rDNA. So each bacterium is containing a gene of interest. Thus the gene of interest is multiplied, producing the identical copies. This is the amplification of gene of interest, and this is nothing but culturing the transformed cells in the medium. This is the a schematic representation of RDNA technology. At one side, we can make out the isolation of gene of interest either by genomic library or by cDNA technology. The vector DNA is taken. The vector DNA treated with the REN like EcoR1 to cut it open. The gene of interest having the staggered cut introduced into the cut open plasmid to create RDNA. RDNA is introduced into the bacteria by different methods. The gene is transferred to bring about transformation of the bacteria. Then the transformed bacteria screened, selected and cultured in a culture medium to get the gene clone.